Yeah, well, you know, Dave and I, when we were in the south of France, where we did most of the recording of The Wall, we had a quite serious disagreement about the recording of Comfortably Numb, which was very much a team effort because let's not forget, we were working as well with Bob Ezrin, who was co-producing the record with me and Dave. And when the multitracks went to New York, Dave and I didn't go with them. Neither did Ezrin. They went off and they arrived, and Michael Kamen then took them into a studio, and he wrote all those great charts for Comfortably Numb on his own, which is pretty extraordinary. A lot of the other stuff that he did for it, he took off my demos and things, you know, things like Is There Anybody Out There and things are sort of exact copies of the demos that I've made.
What was the disagreement then between what you know? Oh, it was a fundamental disagreement, wasn't it, between
I'll
you and
it,
Dave?
Yeah, it's really, really simple. It's probably one story that where his memory and my memory would probably be almost exactly the same, and it was that we had made a rhythm track, so that would be like drums, bass, guitar, whatever, and I loved it. And he thought it wasn't precise enough rhythmically, and recut the drum track and there's something else, and said, "There, that's better." And I listened to it, and I went, "No, it's not. I hate that." And he went, "Oh, it's so." So that was all the disagreement was. And in the end, the track that is on the record is, you know, the first verse is from the version I liked, then the second verse is from the version he liked, and then there's a bit of chorus from my one and a bit of it. So we
compromise.
It was a negotiation and a compromise.
But it was very fine margins, wasn't it, by the sound of it?
Margins
of perfection.
Yeah, neither he nor I would accept that. You know, it's a very strange thing when you're a musician and you work in these things. There are things that to a layman might seem like nothing, are really kind of glaring and jarring on the air. Though I did read that David said somewhere or other about that, telling the same story, and he has the same story as me because I've read it somewhere. He said probably if we listened to it now, we wouldn't be able to tell the difference.